Hello everyone, I am Divyanshu Kumar and today I will be discussing Code Forces Round 635 Division 2 Problem D. Now this video is a continuation of binary search tutorial. So if you have not seen that video, I would suggest you to pause this video now and first watch that video, because I will be using the concepts I explain, concepts and code I explain in those video, in that video here. Or if you know already them, then it is no issue at all, right? So basically, let's get started. So basically, in this question, we were given that now Xenia is a girl and she has these red gems, NR red gems of different weights, right? Green gems NG and blue gems NB, right? So basically, these are the total number of gems she had. And then basically what she wants to do is choose a gem X from red, okay, X red, right, and Y from green and Z from blue, such that this value, that is, you know, the difference, the mean square difference between all the pairs is minimum. So basically X minus Y whole square plus Y minus Z whole square plus Z minus X whole square is minimum, right? Now you have to minimize this. Now one brute force way to do this would be simple, like for I equal to 1 to NB, NR, choose a red value, right? And for J equal to 1 to NG, choose a green value, okay? And then for K equal to 1 to NK, choose a blue value. NB, it should be not K, right? It should be NB here, NB, right? Choose a blue values. Then basically, then you can just say like, okay, X equal to red of I, Y equal to green of J, and Z equal to blue of K. And then basically just compute the value. That is nothing but, let me just call it result. Let me just call it temp, and then temp equal to X minus Y whole square plus Y minus Z whole square plus Z minus X whole square. Now then just you can just do that result equal to minimum of result and temp, or let me write it here, basically next here, then basically result equal to minimum of result and temp value, and then basically just close all these loops. So basically, and then here you should have initiated result equal to long max or int max, something, right? So as you get the minimum value here, right? Now basically if you see this code, now this code has complexity of O of NR into NG into NB, right? And then just basically considering like, okay, all these values are equal, just for instance, right? Then basically you will have O of N cube complexity, right? Just considering they are all equal to N, suppose. Then you have O of N cube complexity, and it was given that each of them can range to a value of 10 raised power 5. Now, if you have 10 raised power 5 N, then you cannot have a N cube solution. Obviously, it will fail, right? So basically what you can do is simply just sort all the values, sort all of red R plus NR, sort all the green values, green plus NG, and sort all the blue values. And then basically what you can do is, suppose if you have sorted arrays, and then you just if you see here X, Y, and Z, you have to minimize the difference. Suppose if you take Y as the median point and you want to choose the nearest value from red and the nearest value from blue. And suppose like for each of the green you did this, then you will have N into, just finding this red will give you again N, and again a blue will be giving you again N, right? So basically you have N into N plus N. If you do a linear search in red and blue for finding the closest value to Y, right, when you are means like so basically what I'm trying to do here is I'm just trying to iterate over from I equal to 0 to ng, 1 to ng basically, right? So basically 1 to ng, and I'm trying to get like, okay, my green value is, let me just call it tg, like it is g of I. And then basically what I'm trying to do is get something like closest value from red, closest from red. Now this is a linear function here. So basically this will give me a O of n, and y is equal to closest of, z as closest of from blue with value, tg. Here also I should have given an argument as well, right? So basically what I'm trying to do here is finding the closest value to tg from r and finding the closest value from z. Now basically what you can do is like this. If you will do, then you have a n square solution, because n into n plus 2n means just you can consider like, okay, so it will be 2 of n square. If you just consider that the median value is from green, but the median value can be from red, the median value can be from blue. Now what I mean is, suppose like you have the closest value as 5, 3, 3. So basically the median value is from either green or blue, right? You can also have something like 3, 4 and 2. So basically the median value here is from red, okay? Then basically you have the closest value as 4 from green and 2 from blue. If you take similarly, if you suppose consider the median value as 4 in this case, why it is like, if you just consider the median value from one color, you will not get a correct answer, is suppose like you have only one value in that range, from suppose like if you want to select only the red value, and you will just use like this as the median value, then what you can get is basically suppose it has only two values, 1 and 100. So basically, and then let me write it a bit clearly. I don't know why I write so bad. My handwriting is sometimes very bad. So only two values, 1 and 100, right? And basically here you have, let's just say 5 and 50, or let me just call it 55, okay? 55 and 50, okay? And also, let's just say like 30, right? And here you have 3. And 2. So basically if you just consider this as the mid value, then the closest value you can get is 30 and 3, right? But you can have a better solution as well. Why I'm telling like, okay, let me just consider this as 102, then I think you will be able to get. So basically if you just consider 55 as your let me just consider this as 52. Now, if you just consider 55 as the median value, then your difference will be 100 and here 52. So then basically your consecutive difference will be very less comparative to other cases. So basically if you have three values, or just think it this way, like you have an array of three values, right? You don't know the order in which they are arranged. And then so basically the median value can take three places, just the combinatorics approach, right? If you just think like, okay, I don't know, I selected the three values. Now how can you distinguish, means like in what ways can you select like the median value? You will have three ways, then two ways for this and one way for this, right? So basically similar, the same approach I am considering here, right? So basically what I am trying to do is, then basically for each of the value I am trying to find the closest value for red, the closest value for blue, this is for red just say, and the closest value for blue, the closest value for green. But if you see our code, the code is O of n square, right? Can we make it a bit better? I think we can, because the linear function we are using here, the closest function, what we are trying to iterate from 0 to n and finding the best value. Instead, we can just use the binary search function which we used in the previous video, where we used it to get the closest value here. So basically, if you just see like this one, so basically the closest value in binary, in, you know, log n time, so this will result me in a log n complexity, right? And then the search function will now be a, you know, a log n function, or, you know, it will have a complexity of log, right? So basically log n, and then so basically now my complexity will be O of n log n, and I think that can pass, right? So basically that will be you know, easy. So but just to understand this, you know, what is happening in this binary function, this is a slight verification modification of a binary function, right? So if you do, if you want to understand it more detail, the link to my previous video will be in the comments, just go through that. Okay, so let me just integrate it all parts by part. So basically in the solve test case function, I am taking input, like how many the given gems are there, and then basically I'm just inputting the values in array RGB, and then basically I'm just sorting it, because to use a binary search function, the arrays should be sorted, right? That is the, you know, the first criteria. That's why I sorted them, and then basically I'm just checking what is the closest value. I'm just checking like, okay, the temporary green is equal to G of I, and what is the closest value for this GI value from red, and what is the closest value from the blue value, and then I'm just computing the, you know, the difference of x minus y whole square, y minus z whole square, x minus z whole square, right? And then I'm just comparing it min weight. Now min weight, I initialize it to long max, so as I can get the minimum weight obtained through this process, right? And similarly, this is the same process continued for the red one, and similarly the same process continued for the blue one. So basically I'm just finding, I'm assuming like each of these value will act as a median, right? So the overall complexity for this is O of 3 into n into log n, right? So I think which is almost equal to O of n log n, you can just say, because 3 is a constant and you can ignore it. So basically then this solution will pass, and I think this gave me a correct answer during contest, right? So basically this is how you can just use a binary function to optimize, binary search function to optimize your searching. The binary function just reduces the complexity from O of n to O of log n, and that can be very much useful in many places. Now many people will say, why not use a lower bound here? So basically lower bound is very good, like lower bound or upper bound, that are the STL defined binary search functions, but it can be useful when you want to find like exactly that value or greater than that or something like that. So sometimes it is better to write your own approach, own implementation of binary search. It depends on the need of the question, right? Suppose I may use a lower bound if I just want to find the exact occurrence. Suppose the question was something like, does she have the exact weight in the green and blue as well? So basically just she has to select the three same weighted gems. Of course, then other way to solve that question would be just using three different pointers and then sorting it, not using a binary search, of course. But just I'm telling, like, if you want to do a binary search in that case, then a lower bound would be helpful, more helpful. So basically all these approaches have different applications. Once you do more of practice, you will get to know where to apply which one, right? And then so basically in this approach, if you have any doubts, do mention them in the comment section below. Do subscribe to my channel for more such content, and yeah, happy coding. Thank you.